If you are in the market to buy an Apple Watch SE or a Series 3 Apple Watch, watch this video and I'm going to explain why I think a second-hand Series 4 Apple Watch is your best buy. So I have been wearing a Series 4 Apple Watch every day pretty much for about 18 months, and I must admit I was skeptical about whether or not I'd like the Apple Watch when I first bought it. And now I've got it, I don't think I can go back. It's just such a useful thing to always have on your wrist, and it is probably one of my favourite purchases. If you time your purchase with one of the eBay sales where you get 20% off everything on eBay, which they do probably every other month, you can pick up a Series 4 Apple Watch in the 40mm size, which is the same size that I have, for £160, and that is about £100 cheaper than the Apple Watch SE, and it's about £40 cheaper than the Apple Watch Series 3. So why is a second-hand Series 4 a better buy than the SE and the Series 3? Performance. The Series 4 is using the Apple Watch S4 chip, whilst the SE is running on the S5 chip. However, there is no performance difference between the S4 and the S5 chip, and the Apple Watch Series 3 is running on the S3 chip, which actually is notably slower than the S4 chip. So the Series 4 is considerably quicker than the cheapest brand new option from Apple, and it's no slower than the special edition watch from Apple. The S6 chip, which is the chip that you'll find in the Apple Watch Series 6, is quicker than the S4 chip. However, I have never found that performance is an issue on my Apple Watch Series 4. What do you need performance gains for on a watch? You're not really playing games or anything. App loading time is quick enough, and everything just works quickly, and you never really notice performance. I can assure you that the Series 4 will have at least 3 years of software updates because the Series 3 is still for sale on the Apple website now, and the Series 3 is older and slower than the Series 4. In addition, the Apple Watch SE is running a chip that is the exact same speed as the Series 4, and that is a brand new Apple Watch, so you're guaranteed software updates for many years to come. Display. The Series 4 has got the same display size and display as the Apple Watch SE, which is a bigger display than the Apple Watch Series 3. All of these watches, if you're looking for like a cheap Apple Watch, don't have an always-on display. If you want an always-on display, you'll have to get a Series 5 or a Series 6. However, I've never wanted an always-on display or felt the need for it. The Apple Watch is very good at knowing when you're looking at it. Just an ever so tiny flick of the wrist, the screen lights up and it's there, ready for you to look at. I wouldn't want an always-on display because I find that even if I'm looking at my screen at night, like your wrist is literally glowing. You don't really want to be the guy at a pub or a restaurant in the evening with the glowing wrist. I just think it would look a little bit weird. From reviews that I've watched, people end up turning off their always-on display. The Apple Watch Series 4 display is better than the Series 3 and is the same as the Apple Watch Special Edition. And it's not always on, but it's more than good enough for most use cases. The Series 4 Apple Watch is actually a better fitness tracker than the Special Edition and the Series 3. It's got an improved heart rate monitor over the Series 3, and the Special Edition also has these improvements. But the Series 4 has the ECG monitor. This is the electronic cardiograph. I don't find that I actually use this feature very often, but it's nice to have, and you'll be buying the cheaper watch that has more features, so can't complain there. The Series 6 has the blood oxygen feature. However, the Series 6 is considerably more expensive, and I don't necessarily think that it's that useful to have at the moment. I've looked at reviews and read a lot of things. There's definitely skepticisms about the accuracy of the blood oxygen meter, so I think that at the moment, in this stage, the blood oxygen meter isn't really needed or worth it because it's not very accurate. Battery. The biggest concern when you buy something secondhand is battery health. So my Series 4 is currently on 92% battery health, and it lasts me through a day. I charge it in the morning and then I wear it all throughout the day, and I sleep with my Apple Watch on, and then it gets me through the night, and then I just whack it on charge again in the morning. I tend to finish every day with 60%, and then I wake up in the morning with around 40% left. The only sort of exception to this rule is if I'm going on a really long walk and I've got the fitness tracker turned on, so I'm measuring my heart rate and it's using GPS to measure where I'm walking. I can kill an Apple Watch in a day, meaning I have to charge it when I get home for a little bit before I go to bed. But most of the time, I can just wear it all day and all night and only have to charge it in the morning, and I don't really have a problem. I think you'll find the battery life is very similar between the Series 3, the Series 4 and the Special Edition. Like, I don't think it's really going to be too much of a problem. It might be slightly better on the SE, but I don't think it's really something that you'll notice, because you'll just whack it on charge for a little bit in the morning and it doesn't take that long. I just charge it whilst I shower. So to conclude, I think that a Series 4 Apple Watch is one of your better options if you are in the market to purchase a budget Apple Watch. So if your choices are the SE or the Series 3, the Series 4 is cheaper than both of them if you get it secondhand on eBay, and you can get it really, really cheap if you pick it up on somewhere like Facebook without a warranty. The performance is the same as the Special Edition and better than the Series 3. It's got more features than the Special Edition and the Series 3. So I think it's a pretty good idea to get one. You're guaranteed a lot of software updates within the future, and you don't really need any better performance than the Series 4, because you don't play games or do that much on your watch. All you want it to do is last through the day, have a good heart rate tracker, and also be a good fitness tracker. That's all you sort of need from it, and you don't necessarily need app times to load half a second quicker, because you just don't notice it. I've never thought that my Apple Watch is slow. But yeah, I hope this was something that was maybe interesting if you're in the market to buy an Apple Watch at the moment, and let me know what you decide to go on. This is my third video in a tech style video. So again, I'm still in the process of finding my feet and learning. At the moment, I'm basically just doing stuff on things that I own, which is, I'm running out of electronics that I own. So I'm gonna try and come up with some new ideas for how I'm gonna make videos. Anyway, all the best. Subscribe if you enjoy. Don't subscribe if you don't. Catch you again.